This is the Schmo with the pro, C.T. Fletcher, the motivational man, escaped death multiple times. You're an inspiration. Proud to be next to you.
I'm proud to be next to you, Schmo. I wasn't expecting this high honor to be sitting right next to the Schmo.
Now, you've escaped death 5 times. Heart stopped beating, man. And you're still a positive guy with a smile on your face. What motivates you to keep going forward?
I have a whole set of different motivations now. Some of you guys know, don't know. I used to be a world champion way back when I was young, back when I was like the Schmo here.
You set the world record.
Yes.
Biceps and chest press.
Yeah, six-time world champion. And that was my motivation back when I was a young man. But after you die 5 times, you have a different motivation. My motivation now, Schmo, is to just bring people together in love.
In love. Now, you've worked with some world-class athletes. I've seen Tyron Woodley over there with the UFC, Terry Crews. Who's been the most inspirational man that you've trained, or woman?
Well, inspiration, I guess inspirational would probably be Terry Crews, because he was the closest to me in age. All the workouts and stuff you see me doing on YouTube, I was 53 years old before I got on YouTube. So I was an old man. What you seen on those videos was just leftovers. Nobody seen me in my prime. So Terry was closest to me in age, so I guess he would be the most motivational.
And when you were setting all those records, you were doing this clean without them steroids.
Yes. Yeah, I tell everybody now, my son is Samson Fletcher. He's better than I am, because when I was 22, I had people peer pressure me into giving them a try. And I tried them for about 6 months. And you want to know why I quit them, so why I couldn't do it?
Couldn't get it up, I guess, there, CT.
You must have been listening to my videos or listening to the Joe Rogan podcast, if that's exactly right. And one thing I like much more than weightlifting and any other activity is sex.
Right.
If that won't make you quit, I don't know what will. So it was 6 months experience, so I tried them out. Wasn't for me. Fuck them.
Now, you're not afraid to face adversity, being on your deathbed and everything like that. What would you say throughout your career has been the most challenging component outside of being on the deathbed?
Ooh, outside of being on the deathbed, I guess the most challenging thing was getting rid of all the hate that I had. And it was really, I had a very rough childhood, very rough upbringing. So it was really hard, challenging to get rid of the hate that was instilled in me as a kid.
If you had your perfect world, we're living in a difficult time. There's a lot of division and hatred. If you could have things the C.T. Fletcher way, what would that look like?
It would look like, everybody not looking at the exterior of people. Because if you dig just a little bit deeper, you find out that we are all the same under the bar. I like to say it in that's weightlifting term, but what it means, that we are all the same underneath. I had the opportunity to go to many different countries, Russia, Middle East, to name just a few. And once you get to walk amongst the people, you know, forget what you see on the news. And once you get to walk amongst the people, you'll find that we all have something in common, that we all combine together. It's not race, it's the human race that matters. And if I could get people to, you know, love each other, that would be my perfect world.
We're the only species on this planet that we know of to remove ourselves from the food chain. We got to get along, right?
That's it. That's it, Schmo. We must get along.
Now let's quickly transition to some training, because the Schmo admires your physique at one point in time. You really know how to do the biceps. If the Schmo really wants to get the veins and the arms pumping up, what do you recommend I do? What kind of set? I got the motivation. I listen to you. What can I do to really get the biceps to look like yours?
Well, it's the mindset is absolutely the most important thing about it. You've seen a video where I said I command you to grow.
I did, yes.
Talking to my biceps, and people say, that's a fucking lunatic. That guy is crazy. But I talk to my biceps. You don't see anybody preaching that until my old ass got on there and said, hey, you got to get inside the muscle, mentally get inside the muscle. And as far as physicality, the physical movements itself, you must include, after you do your normal sets and reps, you must include one set of until you can't do no motherfucking more.
Until failure.
Yes. And I mean, when I say failure, I want every last drop,
smoke. Drop, schmo.
Everything.
Everything.
Smoke. All you got, smoke.
Give it all the schmo out there.
All the smoke got to be laying on the motherfucking floor.
On the motherfucking floor.
That's it, smoke.
C.T. Fletcher, everybody. And lastly, I'll get you out of here on this. What's your one piece of advice for all the schmoes out there that have never stepped foot in the gym because they're too afraid of what other people are going to think about them when they step foot in the gym?
First of all, fuck them. You ain't doing it for them. You're doing it for your damn self. And don't wait, because time is precious. Don't wait. Don't put it off for tomorrow. Fuck tomorrow. You don't know if you're going to see tomorrow. Do that shit right the fuck now.
Right now, C.T. Fletcher. Live for today, not for tomorrow. We're out.
All right.